C by Senator Orr. This bill would provide for licensure of school psychologists and create a pilot program with the State Education Department, OMH, Office of Alcoholism and Substance Abuse Services to focus on prevention of heroin and opioid abuse in children under 21. There are memos of support from the New York Association of School Psychologists, the Westchester County Psychological Association, and a coalition letter from New York State Association of School Business Officials, the Council of School Superintendents, the New York State School Boards Association, the School Administrators Association of New York State, the New York Council of Administrators of Special Education, and the New York State Alliance for Children with Special Needs. There are memos of opposition from the New York State Psychological Association and the New York State Association of Neuropsychologists. This bill passed the Senate last year, and if this bill is reported, it will be referred to Finance.
Okay.
Move it.
Any...
Yes, I have a number of questions, quick questions.
Yes.
Thank you. Obviously, we understand the need. Medicaid reimbursement. Is there any for... Would there be any under...
It is not within the pages of this bill.
And they have chosen this particular area of psychology, they've chosen not to provide Medicaid reimbursement where they do for other people practicing psychology.
I believe so, but I'll double check.
Yeah, I think that's outrageous, I must tell you. But, does this change the scope of practice at all for the psychologists, for the school psychologists?
No, it doesn't. What it does is they're continuing to do what they're currently doing, but they're asking for licensure. The one piece would obviously be that they can also work outside the four walls of the school, but there's a specific provision within the bill that says that there can't be any conflicts of interest. If they're working with a child inside the school, they cannot provide any services outside the school to the same child in a private practice setting. So there's already protections for conflict of interest.
So it's a geographic limitation.
Yes, and obviously we've had settings restrictions in some other professions, and we've been working to change that because obviously the nature and landscape of mental health has changed.
And if I may, one of the challenges, or one of the impetus has been, it's been tough to get children psychologists into schools. One of the reasons for that, or the thought process, is because they're, once they say yes, they're then limited. So if you allow them to continue to practice, you may gain more folks to go in schools and provide those services. So that's...
And my questions are not meant...
No, that's fine.
...to in opposition, because if it comes to the floor, I'd rather raise the questions here. And so you were, in a sense, saying that there are other professions in the school that are not affected by this. I assume you mean the social workers, the school social workers and other...
Yeah, they wouldn't be. This is specifically about raising from certification to licensure for school psychologists.
I understand that, and that is an issue of changing certification to licensure, not just the school psychologists, but many of the other professions which have licensure, certification, and that you want to raise it to licensure. Are we lowering the standards of psychologists in any way?
I don't believe so at all, because at the end of the day, what this prescribes for is 60 graduate credits at a minimum. It's an advanced specialist degree or PhD, so it's above master's level.
That was my object of my question. It is, is the service at the doctoral level?
It can be advanced specialist or doctoral.
So it is not at the doctoral level, where other areas of practice of psychology require a doctor.
Mm-hmm.
Section, I think it was 6, talks about a pilot program for the opioid addiction problem. And interestingly, it has a September 2018 implementation date, but this bill doesn't take effect for another 12 months after it's enacted. How do you reconcile those differences?
So how we reconcile this is obviously they're going to be working on a pilot program with current school psychologists and other mental health professionals, and that's something that's important and necessary to happen as soon as possible. So what the goal would be is to work on this multi-tiered system of support in this pilot program, while everything else is happening behind the scenes with SED, obviously, for bringing it up to licensure. So obviously, if there are any issues with the date, we can certainly discuss that.
And I noticed the memo said it will be self-sustaining because of the licensure fees. Is there any guarantee that the State Education Department will use the licensure fees for this purpose?
I mean, that's the common practice with SED, is for every single profession, it's the same thing. So I don't see why there would be any issue with that.
Okay, there are other issues. I have reservations about the bill, but I will be voting yes. But I think you've got to have parity within the profession and not different standards for school psychologists than for other the others, whether they be whatever the license psychology is. And thank you for your answer.
Yeah. Senator, stay with the bill. Give to the sponsor whatever.
Mm-hmm. These are my scribbles reading it, but. Okay. These were the questions. Okay.
This is a critical bill.
The need for school psychologists is overwhelming.
Well, we need practitioners out in the community that deal with young adults, mm-hmm. and they're far and few between. So I've been involved with the sponsor to tweak this bill because it's a bill that has to get done. We need to start moving forward so that we're putting people out into the highways and byways in our district to deal with young adults that are struggling. And I've been, principal of a school, psychologist. The amount of time that they can spend in school with kids is very, very few hours. So we really need to do whatever it is. And of course, the sponsor is very amenable to having input, make his bill the best bill that it can be.
Yeah, my concern, the reason I'm voting for it, quite frankly, is because of the need for the school psychologists. I turned it off.
There's one calling you right now.
Message, sorry.
Oh,
it's all right.
So help
me, I turned it off.
Any other comments?
Well, Mr. Chairman, I would just reiterate the points you were making, as well as Senator Stavisky, for that matter. When I speak with my school superintendents, obviously they're concerned about state aid. But right up there on the list is, in the last few years, has emerged the need for more mental health services, yes, in our schools. And anything we can do to help upgrade that and to better provide those services, very, very important.
My concern is that you don't call them psychologists. The need is there, but we've got to make sure that we don't water down the standards. That's really what. But I intend to, because of the need.
Okay. Any other comments? Any negative votes? Bill is reported.
The second bill on the agenda is Senate Bill 1243 by Senator LaValle. This bill would extend TAP eligibility by 2 semesters for students forced to transfer to another college in the event that their current college permanently closes. There are no memos of support or opposition for this bill. If this bill is reported, it will be referred to Finance.
Any comments? Negative votes?
I have one question.
Yes.
Does it apply to proprietary schools?
It would apply.
One in my district closed.
Yes, it would apply to every school.
Every school, yeah. That has TAP.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And this was originally because of the whole Dowling College situation, but obviously we're seeing more schools close.
I would say to those in Western New York, you might have some problems up there. There are several schools that, as they say, have one foot on a banana peel and the other in bankruptcy.
Is that the thing?
What?
Is that the same? I've never heard that.
But
bankruptcy. There's some variation
on
that.
Bankruptcy is literally trying to make it appropriate.
I'm going to start using that a lot.
All right. But we know what you mean, Mr. Chairman.
Phyllis reported.
The third bill on the agenda is Senate Bill 1380A by Senator LaValle. This bill would create a process for summary suspension of a professional license and an expedited hearing on such suspension in the case where such licensee causes or engages in conduct that constitutes an imminent danger to the public health and or safety. This bill would also make conforming changes to professions that did not have a good moral character requirement. There are no memos of support or opposition for this bill. This bill passed the Senate last year, and if this bill is reported, it will be referred to Finance.
Any comments? Negative votes? Bill is reported.
One without recommendation.
Yes.
From Senator Krueger.
Senator Krueger without recommendation.
The fourth bill on the agenda is Senate Bill 3851 by Senator LaValle. This bill would allow non-CPAs to be minority owners of a CPA firm and allow non-CPAs to form a partnership with a CPA. There is a memo of support from the Business Council. There are no memos in opposition. If this bill is reported, it will go to the floor.
State Society supports.
Mm-hmm. Any comments? Negative votes? Bill is reported.
The fifth bill on the agenda is Senate Bill 5801 by Senator LaValle. This bill would provide for a loan forgiveness program for dental faculty. Annual awards will be made up to $40,000 for a total of $160,000. There are memos of support from NYU, Columbia University, and University of Rochester. There are no memos of opposition. This bill passed the Senate last year, and if this bill is reported, it will be referred to Finance.
Any comments? Negative vote?
Question, quick question. Is there an appropriation of any sort?
There's no appropriation. It's a dry.
To dry
bill right now.
Right now.
Negative votes? Bill is reported.
The sixth bill on the agenda is Senate Bill 7594 by Senator Golden. This bill would extend limited licenses for restricted dental faculty until 2021. There are memos of support from Columbia University and University of Rochester. There are no memos of opposition, and if this bill is reported, it will go to the floor.
Any comments? Negative votes?
I have.
Yes.
This is the kind of bill, I think, that should not be sunsetting every 2 years.
Okay.
For the record, I obviously support it. Secondly, the effective date of the bill is immediate, but the current statute doesn't expire until February 1st of next year. I'll point that out.
I think we want to bring to the sponsor's attention an amendment to not have it sunset.
Yeah.
Okay.
I mean, if it's a good bill, it's a good bill. It's save the taxpayers the trees.
Okay. Bill is reported.
The last bill on the agenda is Senate Bill 8088 by Senator LaValle. This bill would extend the effective date of enactment for licensure of pathologist assistants to July 1st, 2018. There is a memo of support from Greater New York Hospital Association. There are no memos of opposition. And if this bill is reported, it will go to the floor.
Any comments? Negative votes? Bill is reported. Thank you.